Hey, what's up guys? Indian Sensei here. Welcome to another episode of Ninja Voltage. So today we are gonna look at the top trap clearing jutsus as of now in the game. And we are not gonna discuss whether they are good in attack mission or anything like that. We just gonna rank the jutsus on basis of range, special effects on users, etc. But before that, I wanna share a moment with you. You see that red indicator on the achievement icon? Yeah, let's see what's there. Yeah, it's the 150 Shinobites, and I was not able to get them last team attack mission, but this time I did it. So yeah, I know many of you guys might have got them already, but for me this was an accomplishment which I wanted to share with you. So let's accept. Yeah, so we are done with that, and we have one more achievement waiting, so let's see this in the future. But let's jump into the video now. So at 9th position we have Edo Minato trap clearing jutsu, and as you can see the range is like half of the room, a very short range, and it says unidirectional. I mean, it goes forward in a straight line of one square, and it can set up traps in both the squares, but you need to have a very good angle for that. In this case, I know where the traps are, so I am using it like that, but in any other attack mission this can happen easily. So you cannot be sure of the direction during attack mission, so you cannot be sure of the trap clearing jutsu just by using it once, so you will have to use like it multiple times so that you are sure of that there are no more traps. And another bad thing about the trap clearing jutsu of Edo Minato is this, the weird traps. So as soon as he gets stuck in a weird trap, the trap clearing jutsu is over and your time as well as the CP cost is wasted. Although his trap clearing jutsus destroys the walls if he encounters any, but he gets stuck in beer trap. So yeah, there is that. So that's why he is at 9th position. They could have made him better. So at number 8 we have OG Naruto's trap clearing jutsu. You can say Edo Minato's trap clearing jutsu is a downgraded version of OG Naruto, because it's a half room and this one is a full room. So if you start from one point of the room, it goes to the end of the room, so it's really good as compared to Edo Minato's. But again, it's a unidirectional, I mean it goes in a single square line. To get two squares you need to have a good angle, which is really not possible during attack mission because you don't know where the traps are. And fun fact though, OG Naruto's trap clearing jutsu was the very first trap clearing jutsu which we got in the game, and at that time after his re-kit, he was like the best attack mission player as well as best in defense. So yeah, but again he faces the same issues as his father, that his trap doesn't go over beer traps. He can destroy walls, but as soon as he faces a beer trap, it's useless. So especially he is a red character, so his CP cost is high, and you really cannot afford to waste CP on using the trap clearing jutsu multiple times. So yeah, that's a con on his case, but his trap clearing is still full room, so he is better than Edo Minato, I will say. So yeah. So at number 7 we have Shino with us, and Shino's trap clearing jutsu is better than OG Naruto because it's like 2 square line forward instead of 1, and it covers the full room as OG Naruto. But again, sometimes if the angle is really bad, you can miss like 1 or 2 traps here and there, but it's really better than OG Naruto because of the two lines that goes forward. But then again, he faces the same problem as Edo Minato and OG Naruto. His trap clearing bugs, get stuck in beer traps as well as walls. And so yeah, there you have it. His trap clearing is not perfect. This is a really bad problem we have with his jutsu. So at number 6 we have Rin with us. So Rin's trap clearing jutsu has a very short range, I mean like it doesn't even go like half of the room, but it covers like 3 squares forward in the direction of the log, so it's really good. And fun fact that her trap clearing jutsu was the very first one which goes over walls in this game, so yeah, it's really useful when you can use it like that way. So So it's really useful like this way if you use it over walls in attack mission. But again, she has the same problem with her log that it gets stuck. I mean, it gets ended after it hits a weird trap or something like that. So yeah, again, the same problem with her trap clearing jutsu as we have seen so far with the other shinobis. So yeah. So at number 5, we have Temari's new trap clearing jutsu, which is really good. I mean, it also inflicts confusion and stays for like 4-5 seconds. So it also goes over walls and stuff and doesn't stuck in bear traps and stuff. And also you can use it from a long range. I mean, to use it on enemies so that they can get continuously hit by the tornado, we can say. So it's really good, I mean. And also the range is quite decent. It could be better, but I will say it's really decent. And yeah, so she is at number 5 because the jutsu she got was really good, this re-kit. Sadly, I don't have it, so I will have to use it the trial run to show you. Yeah. At number 4, we have my personal favorite Hokage Naruto's trap clearing jutsu. I mean, his jutsu is an advanced version of OG Naruto. Instead of just one clone, he sends 4 clones forward with their own Rasengan and covers the full room. But it's still a unidirectional jutsu. I mean, it covers a single straight line of one square each. But if you use it like in a good angle, same as OG Naruto, you can cover like 2 squares line forward. But yeah, it's still good. I mean, as soon as his re-kit was introduced, he immediately became one of the best attack mission player at that time, as well as a good defender. I mean, he is still good in attack missions and defense, but he stayed there for like 1 year, but after that he dropped down to like S or A rank, I'm not sure, but he is really good and he has been my personal attack mission shinobi for a long time because of this trap clearing jutsu. And yeah, but it doesn't goes over through walls because it's, you know, you can imagine it's shadow clone jutsu, so it doesn't go through walls. But yeah, it's really good. Again, he has the same problem as OG Naruto, that his shadow clone gets stuck in bear trap, but as you can see, he sends out 4 clones, so it really isn't that much of a problem as compared to OG Naruto and Shino and Edo Minato. He can just clear out any bear traps easily with his 4 clones, as you can see. I mean, it's really isn't that bother, but I mean, it's really good. It's better than OG Naruto because he has like 4 clones, so he can avoid the bear traps easily that way. So at number 3, we have Sage of Six Path Trap Clearing Jutsu, which we got for free from Sam. And it is one of the best Trap Clearing Jutsus in the game as of now, and which made him a very good attack mission main. I think he's S+. He was a meta, but I think he got down. But he is still a very good attack mission player because of his Trap Clearing Jutsu. His Trap Clearing Jutsu is like almost full room, almost you can say. Like 70% squares forward, but not full room, but it's really good. And as you can see, you can use it once and clear a whole lot of area with traps. So yeah, and his jutsu goes over walls, so that's really good. Also, he doesn't face any kind of the bear trap problem. He just activates them and they get destroyed. So yeah, this is a really good trap clearing jutsu, as you can see. That's why he has number 3. Now let's jump on to number 2. At second position, we have Tenten's new 4 star, which we got from Sam, which not only clears traps but also gives like attack and evasion buff to Tenten, as well as inflicts dot damage to the enemies. So that's a really nice thing to be given to a 4 star which in clear traps. Also, if I use it like this way horizontally, you can see it clears the whole floor with the traps horizontally forward. So that's really nice, and she doesn't face any kind of bear trap problem, as you can see. They just get cleared and destroyed after she uses her 4 star. At number 1, we have DMS Kakashi. His trap clearing is number 1 because it's a very good iframe, plus it decreases evasion of enemies and also gives attack and critical buff to himself. So the range is also decent, like almost half room forward, and the good thing is not only it sets off trap, but it destroys the walls and installations among the traps so that your support shinobis don't run towards an aroma or a wall. He can have some CP issues along the way, but it can be managed with some blue cards and stuff. That's why he is still a top tier solo as well as team main. He also doesn't have any problems with beer traps or walls. He just sets them off and they get destroyed easily.
So that was my opinion on the ranking of trap killing jutsus, guys. And for any of you who are wondering, I got 236 rank this sem, and I was not aiming for top 100, but in helping in my own guild, I unknowingly pushed my rank to 236, and this was my guild rank 100, right? Pretty cool. So we made a new guild and were able to secure 100 rank as a new guild, all thanks to my fellow guild members. So yeah, so hope you guys liked the video. Make sure to leave a comment and like. Do subscribe if you haven't already. And join my social medias and Discord. Links are in description. Until next time. Sayonara.